and gentlemen, Louis C.K.
Hi. It's a little early for that. Well, thank you very much for being here. This is the 40th year of this show's existence, and this is the finale, so I'm very honored, honestly, to be asked to host it. So thanks, and I'm glad you guys are here. Yeah, it's fine. Anyway, I was born in 1967, and so I grew up in the 70s. So I'm not racist. However, I do have mild racism. It's the best I could do coming out of the 70s, because that was a very racist decade. People said racist things all the time, and nobody got offended. The only time somebody got offended if you said something racist in the 70s is when they would then say, like, hey, you interrupted me. I was saying something racist. Why did you? So I have mild racism. It's benign. It's not aggressive. It's not even negative racism. It's mild racism. I'll give you an example, okay? Like, see, like if I go to a pizza place I've never been to before, and it's run by four black women, I'll go like, See, it's very mild. It's extremely mild racism. I'll notice that. Yeah. You don't usually see that, four black women running a pizza place. Unless it's called Four Black Girls Pizza or something like that. Like, that's the whole point of the place. It's mild. Here's another example of mild racism. If I say I'm in a hospital and the doctor comes in to treat me and the doctor's from China or India, I'll think, well, good, good. Good, more of that. Why not? It's very mild racism. Here's another example. If I'm in a gas station late at night and a young man comes in wearing a hooded sweatshirt, if he's white, I'll think, oh, he's an athlete. If he's black, unless he has a big smile on his face, then I become mildly racist, and this is what I think. I think, that's fine. Everything's fine. Nothing's gonna happen. No, of course I'm fine. Why did I even think that for a second? This is because I was raised in the 70s. The 70s were a very different time. The 70s, everything was different in the 70s than it is now, except the Middle East is exactly the same. It's exactly the same as it was in the 70s. It's been the same fights, and you know what? It's boring now. That's the worst part of it. When I was a kid, we were like, ugh, but you can't go like this for like 1,000 years. After a while, when you fight, people don't care, because when you're just both, you just keep fighting. Everybody's like, those guys are dicks. They just fight. That's what it's like. You know, like, I have two kids, and they fight sometimes. And when they first start fighting, I get concerned. I go in their room, I'm like, hey, what's going on? What's wrong? Why are we having some feelings? Can we listen to each other, please? Can we please just listen to each other? Okay, you go first. And then she goes, she's like, yeah, that sounds hard. Okay, thank you. Thank you. Okay, now you. Because I like this one a little more, so that's why I make it. And they work it out. You help them work it out. But if they keep fighting, you stop doing that. After a while, you just go in the room and you just go, hey! Just shut up! Fuck you, you're both wrong! Because you won't stop fighting. You're in a family. There's other people in this family, and you're being a couple of selfish little bitches that won't fix anything. You share a room. We can't afford another room, so just deal with it. Somehow this has to do with Israel and Palestine. I don't know exactly. I don't remember how. Because my kids are like Israel and Palestine. And I'm like America. The little one's like Palestine because she always gets screwed. She gets the worst deals. She's like, she threw a rock at my face. I'm like, you're fine. Look, you have a great life. You get to take a rock to the face once in a while. You're fine. The older one is like Israel. She comes up to me, she burnt all my dolls. I'm like, look, I can't do anything about it right now. Your sister is crazy. Please don't make me talk to her. I'll work it out, you and me, okay? We'll go out, I'll buy you a really cool missile, and you do whatever you do with it. It's totally up to you. The 70s were very different. In the 70s, there was a child molester that lived in my hometown. And it wasn't a big deal. It wasn't like, we caught a child molester. It was just like, yeah, that's the house where the child molester lives. He lives where, hey, kids, don't be stupid or you'll get molested. Just stay away from the child molester house. I know because he did something to me when I was your age. So just stay away from the child molester house. We really did. We had a town child molester. His name was Jean Baptiste. It's a true story. He liked teenage boys. That's when you would find out, because I was a teenage boy. He didn't like me. I felt a little bad. Like, no, not you. He wasn't into me. But he would drive up next to teenage boys, and he'd say, hello, would you like to go to McDonald's? And you're like, no. And he's like, why, you don't like McDonald's? And then you're trapped, because of course everybody liked McDonald's. It was the 70s. And then I had one friend who used to get in the car. He'd be like, sure, I'll go. And he'd get in the car. He'd go to McDonald's and eat a burger. And then he'd say, see ya. And he'd just take off. And Jean-Baptiste was like, duh, I did not get to have sex with that child. And he foiled again. But he'd always try. Maybe this time. Because child molesters are very tenacious people. They love molesting childs. It's crazy. It's like their favorite thing. I mean, it's so crazy, because when you consider the risk in being a child molester, speaking not of even the damage you're doing, but the risk, there is no worse life available to a human than being a caught child molester. And yet they still do it, which you can only really surmise that it must be really good. I mean, from their point of view, not ours, but from their point of view, it must be amazing for them to risk so much. How do you think I feel? It's my last show, probably. Look, I can't key into it because I love Mounds bars. I love Mounds bars. It's my favorite thing, right? But there's a limit. I mean, I can't even eat a Mounds bar and do something else at the same time. That's how much I love them. Like, if I'm eating a Mounds bar, I can't read the paper. Like, I have to just sit there with it in my mouth and go, why is this so good? I love this so much. And because they are delicious. And yet, if somebody said to me, if you eat another Mounds bar, you'll go to jail and everybody will hate you, I would stop eating them. Because they do taste delicious, but they don't taste as good as a young boy does and shouldn't to a child molester. Not to me. Not to us, because we're all awesome. All right, we did it. We got through it.
Russia from my house.
New York's hottest club is...
Excuse me!
40 seasons, one app.
Thanks for watching, and remember to subscribe. Every 100th subscriber wins a brand new car! No? Okay, well, scratch that on the car? I don't know why I thought that. I'm sorry. But what do they win? Nothing. Well, then why even subscribe? What do you mean, stop talking?